Oh boy! Yes, it's Fen hacking some saws.
You hear anything?
Oh, and they automatically get alerted. That's frickin' dandy. It's frickin' dandy, and for some reason this isn't wood or something? Like, yeah, I don't know. Serious nonsense. I know you're supposed to use a rope, but seriously, I'm not into spending any more ropes. It's not currency. I know you think it is, but... never mind. I'm gonna try climbing up on this one. Oh my god. Yeah, seriously, it's like... also, I don't think I even can get through this window. So it's like, what even... yeah, what? Yeah, that's weird. It's too thin to get through. I'm pretty darn sure. So what's the sense? No, it's not.
I don't think I can jump up here from that rope.
What? You don't think you can jump up here from that rope? What rope? What jump up where? What? Oh, whatever. Okay. Maybe the Hammerites can cure these people? Better just use holy water, but not any other weapon. Okay, I guess these zombies count as people. Disgusting.
I think I can jump into this window from that rope hanging from the hoist.
It's just as if you come the other way, I guess, or something, because I'm already in the window. Yes, okay, well, point more or less understood anyway. But yeah, so we're in Zombieville. Well, that's different at least. I don't think I have any holy water. So I have to get through. Whoa. Is that a guard or some zomb guard or a ghost guard? A zomb ghost, if you will. So instead of the guy walking around here, it's another guy walking around here in the second mission. Amazing change! Amazing grace! And the heaven water has greened itself to death. And somebody has drowned in it. His blood is green, so you know that he was just playing some Carmageddon 3! Yeah, okay, well, yeah. Not doing that clearly. I don't think I'm doing that clearly. Now, I've been told that if I wish to avoid backtracking or something, that I should go to the place where Keeper Jonas has been murdered. So, okay. Kind of refreshing when I'm forced not to just blackjack everybody in my face. Also, when they're not, like, being stupid and ridiculous about it. Yeah, this guy's not being stupid and ridiculous. He's just kind of walking around in a chill fashion. No problem. He's ice. He's ice. He's ice. He's ice like a freezer. Oh, I like that guy. I keep repeating my catchphrase over and over again. Okay, so be more careful though, and this place is even more broken up than it usually is, and it's quite beautiful in a dark way. Oh, shit. That's an interesting way to loot someone. Interesting face too. Wow, that's some real screenshot material right there. Material, oh shit. Uh-huh. But all right. The sewers are kind of way over somewhere. Ooh, ooh. That's, I guess maybe I can't ever take this path or something? Not sure. Hey, this is kind of cool. I like it. It's undead and weird. Yeah, I think she just turns around and... so unless I can... oh. Nice snorting, piggy diggy, and nice grin. So really, this passage may as well just be blocked off. I don't know. It's kind of interesting. But it looks like they closed the gates to Blackened Skiesville over there. Flim Flam Industries will not be taking over this city. Oh, I like those glowy, shiny, weird lights that are sickeningly hazy. Yeah, sickeningness is healthy. So, the sewers. The sewers. That was actually slightly easier. What have we got here? Wanted. Jared Hopp for thefts, robbery, threats, extortion, arson, Stefan Flea, ridiculing the law, seduction of the noble ladies, Kid Tommy, I see. Not urinating on a grave, unfortunately. Caught, Ben Rocks. Oh. Wasn't that the guy I was supposed to ensure he doesn't get caught or something? Oh, that's unfortunate. Okay, well... Excusez-moi, mademoiselle, monsieur. So yeah, I don't know exactly why I'm going here, but apparently it's extremely imperative that I do. Hopefully we won't encounter any undead and other spooky things that you'd normally find in the sewers. My ticklish nose is not a good thing for being on the mic, but I gotta listen for some zombies first. I guess there are some beasties. Uh-oh. But it's all lit up. Am I supposed to avoid a guy now? For God's sake! Seriously? Okay. Well, that's what I was told. Go down here, but... You'd think that I should have some holy water. My... Insane here? Come on. I can't get past these guys if I just go down here now. Alright. Well... Yeah. Maybe I can... Shit, maybe they'll walk past me if I'm here? I wouldn't want to bet on it. I don't think so. I don't think so. God. Well, that's... Stupid. Alright, hopefully I didn't do anything too punishable there. Okay, not stupid, just challenging. That guy lacks a hand. It's amazing. I really, really like those shadows. I think Soltier is the only one to do these shadows on the guys, and that despite them looking round, it looks sweet, you know? Shadows looking round is a classic gaming thing. You know what I'm saying? Don't know why you wouldn't. Just saying that, because I'm a rapper and I commandeer every single phrase, such as conversate. And then you can,
Looks like these things are what ripped everything apart. So, this was not a hallucination. One of them is still here. I wonder where the others are.
Whoa! Hey. Wow, okay.
Looks like this is what's left of another thing. But what melted it?
Not trying to make noise here. I don't know why I can't go through. There's a spider, like, right frickin' over there. I don't have any arrows for it for some reason. Thank you! Okay. So that's the second time I've seen a tree beast this century. Incredible. So this is how you get back there on the other side, I guess. Or not. I guess that spider's just there to be there.
What a spider. Is it one of those that are no taller than a cat? I wish I could see their cats.
Oh, them Garrett snaps. Okay. Wait, there's something behind here. There's a water arrow. There we go. Maybe another one? Yeah. So, yeah, I guess that spider's just there to be there. Burn to burn, as I was going to say. Okay. So already at 8 freaking minutes here somehow. I'm not sure how that even happened. That's insanity. So I gotta get over there whilst avoiding the quick walker and nightmare dude. Wow, I like that dented door. God damn, there's one thing Soltier does well. It's amazing visuals. Okay, he's stuck against the wall. That's extremely good for me, or it might be very, very bad for me. I don't know. I'm gonna... Oh, shit. I'm gonna find out. Uh-oh. He's got some sort of gem stuck in his chest. So I guess that's his power source. Or it's just blood. Oh my god! I think it's a gem, though. He is a crystal gem. And this show is pretty good. Although the main character has a voice that's kind of literally the exact pitch wherein it makes you tear your ears out. Come on, guys! I'm Steven! I don't know, you guys. I don't know. I'm gonna get lynched for that. Anyway, serious. It's a pretty enjoyable show, but I don't get the huge, enormous hype. Wow, it's pumping blood outwards. I wonder if I can go outwards. And even this door is wrecked up slightly a little bit. Yeah, I wonder if I can go out and, like, come out the start. Probably not, but... Just wanna try. Oh, dude, that is so freaking creepy. No. This is kind of amazing. Also, this looks more like Kool-Aid. Oh, well. Okay. Okay, so. Yeah, I mean, this is interesting because these visuals are kind of new style. You think you could say if I can't take the rap game and turn it the other way and shit? Oh, there's some total blackness.
Interesting. Where's the body gone? Probably I can find something out if I try to concentrate.
Concentrate, okay. Does that mean just like waiting? Oh! Okay. What?
Wow. What is this place? The hideout Jonas wrote about?
This is a hideout? Well, I see somebody. Can I, like, exit by unclicking this, or... No, I guess not. Good. Good. Wow. This is... I've never
what
seen...
What are these things? Look like some kind of portals. Who's this running from... Is it really Jonas?
I never seen nothing like this before. Wow. I'm liking it. Despite everything, you found me. You're more powerful than the Keepers think. I know you have a lot of questions for me. Well, I'll gladly answer them. Nobody will bother us down here. Jonas, what's happening? I'm beginning to think that I'm stuck in a nightmare. The earthquakes, the anomalies, the monsters, the hallucinations, and now the zombies. What's happened to you? What is this strange place? Garrett, that scientist Garam Cresto has managed to create a hole into another dimension, or not to put too fine a point on it, he has removed the barrier between our world. Consequently, our dimensions have started to merge. The creatures and unnatural phenomena from the other world are leeching into ours, and I'm afraid that there are more ominous things coming. As for my feigned death and all that blood, I used it in order to hide from our foes. Garrett, there are some traitors in the Order. They want to use the collapse of the House of Science to acquire the power from the other dimension. If this should happen, our whole world could disappear. The traitors were chasing us both, but alas, I've learned that too late. Nevertheless, thanks to the mage's protective barriers, the villains cannot infiltrate the mansion, but they will follow you until you've opened all of the doors. After that, they will kill you. This all sounds like insanity, but I'm firmly resolved to infiltrate that bloody House of Science, whatever's going on in there. Just tell me exactly how I'm to protect myself from those traitors. And what about this place? Where do all these portals lead to? You know, I've seen something similar back in Roxburgh. I guess this is officially Roxburgh canon? Okay.
All
Keepers, including myself, use glyph magic, but the traitors are very cautious. They conceal themselves in small cells in four-dimensional space. You cannot touch the traitors until they leave their hiding places, but even then you cannot stop them using your arrows or that thing you call a blackjack. These arches go nowhere, and the center is a void. They are like mirrors in a way. Their form is symbolic. I created them using the teaching glyph. The gist of it is that you must learn where your long suit is on your own, and then the mirrors will show you that aspect of your character. What does long suit mean? In other words, you will see a result only when you do something. You called yourself the Master Thief. Well, then try to focus on this part of you and leave no valuables behind. All higher keepers go through this. There are 12 mirrors down here. This number is very important in our universe. If you can show 12 aspects of your character, you automatically get the knowledge of one of the higher glyphs. There's no magic. That's how our universe works. You have already begun to focus on how to find your way in the darkness and to search for the hidden glyphs, but now that you've found this place, you are perhaps capable of something more. Just try to focus again, delve into the depths of your consciousness in order to discover your hidden abilities. Nothing will disturb your mind while you are in the influence of my glyph of silence. Okay, should I use this again? Oh. Enter the void, eh? Fine. Right. What is this strange place? Why did you bring me here? Answer me, Jonas. The thing is... this stuff goes away and I'm so worried about reading it before it goes away that I'm not committing any of this to memory, so excuse me while I commit this to memory. Okay, I think I've got it. Traitors are chasing, they're four-dimensional, they want into the House of Science, the dimensions are merging, these portals are nothing and leave no valuables behind, and I guess I can click that for some reason. Ooh. Ooh, what? Oh, I'm back here. Oh. So, okay, apparently this prevents backtracking. Not sure how. I guess those portals might have something to do with it. Who's this? So that's the deal with that. Okay. I don't know how that... Because it gets me from one place to another. It's a shortcut. Gotcha. Although I still have to go through these nasty old sewers all the time. But still, I suppose that's all right. I should go back and explore the town some more as, supposed to go to Penny's Bar or whatever. This is kind of cool. This part is getting kind of enjoyable. I really like these beasties in this weird, fucked up sewer. Come on, nobody cares. And yeah. Oh, there were lots of ums and ahs and poor editing. Oh, you wouldn't believe it, man. Okay, seriously. Go away. Go the heck away. No, I could use some moss, but... Oh, I'm just in such and awe. That was a pun of the visual design here. It's great. Uh-oh. What? Oh no, I'm gonna get busted now. No, thankfully not. So, I still have to avoid these guys every single time I want to come here, so it's not like it's the greatest shortcut in history or anything, but it's something. At least, I don't know what that keeper meant by leave no valuables behind and like go into the void and freaking whatever. I don't know. I said enter the void, but this isn't the void. This is the real freaking world. So I don't understand what's even going on here. But oh shit. Oh, okay. Wait, this enter the void thing appeared here. It popped up in my inventory for some reason. But. Why? But why? I don't get it. There are mirrors? Why did that thing pop up? Why did I just teleport? Wait. What's going on? Oh, no. Okay, I have no idea why that happened. It happened when I quicksaved. Totally bizarre. Does this mean it's like a place where I should use it or something? But I did, and it just took me back there. I don't understand... Cryptic. Oh well. I think Penny's place is over that away. And that sewer drain opening and closing makes that guy go rrrr and stuff. Wow, it's a headless dude being attacked by a handful woman. No, he's just kneeled down. Okay, fine. I don't know why that's happening. One would possibly expect that isn't supposed to be happening or something. So there's Penny's pub, but it's being guarded. Don't tell me I gotta go around back. I don't have any holy water. I don't have any holy water, do I? Do I have any holy water? No. Okay. Well, I'll try going around here. Do these mines still exist? No. Because the mage is not a vine anymore. The mines have become space. Space mine! Where the hell am I? Ah. Yep, I'm enjoying this fresh take on the city. Come on. Okay. Don't even bother placing it outside. So here I am behind the guy, and he's got a shield. That's kind of interesting. But, okay, this is Penny, so perhaps I need to go up into that window? Yeah. Yeah. Alright, I'll give it a shot. Or not. Well, I don't see any proper wood, unless, of course, this frame is somehow wood, and I just don't realize it. Crates or something? What the devil? Well, I can try to... Oh. Well, that's not really where I'm going, but sure. my picks are now combined because dude just realized halfway through the campaign, he's like, eh, I don't want to use two picks, I'll use one. Okay, well, it's a door I can go in, so maybe it will lead me into some better world. Wow, I think that guy noticed me. It's my magma! What? Okay. Loot, leave no valuables behind. Don't tell me that means I gotta get, like, literally all the loot in order to get some freaking required objective. No, of course not. Valuables probably refer to one's soul. Or some other bullshit like that. Souls are not bullshit. They are real. You can see lost versions of them walking around just outside! No. Okay. I haven't written here for quite a long time, but after the earthquake that barely touched my home, I remembered my diary. For the first time in recent years, I thought about my future again. When I came to Königsforst, I was an energetic and purposeful man. I grasped any chance to work, and soon I became a manager at the wine warehouse. I was completely satisfied with my current job in this apartment. But now, when that nasty earthquake happened nearby, I don't feel I can stay here anymore. Moreover, I'm sure that it's an omen from on high. It's high time I found a congenial woman and created my family. The problem is that I just couldn't bring a woman here because it is too small down here and lodging inside the city walls is too expensive. I think that now I'm experienced and have useful knowledge, I could find a job in another city like Arkford. Or I could go back to my native Fording. So he's taking Roxburgh from Roxburgh, Arkford from Broken Triad, and Fording, I think, from the Seven Sisters. The town's called East Fording. Not sure how to feel about that still. I heard from different people that after the plague outbreak, things are improving there. Yeah, he's referencing, I mean, I guess it's cool to reference, but and then there is Roxburgh, one of the wealthiest cities of the country, but they say that the devilry is going on there. Anyway, it's time to leave this place. Since the new mayor assumed office, Königsforst has been a bad place for mayoring, and also turned from a prospective opportunity for young people into a bastion for the rich. There is nothing to be done here anymore for people like me. Also, that cataclysm is not a matter I should ignore. I just came back home and I feel weird, like dreamy. I left a rather rude message for the guard about the loss of the key, but now it's just occurred to me that it was my own fault because I left the key in the storeroom along with my purse. But I swear I can't remember how exactly it happened. Perhaps I should take a holiday and visit Dr. Norman. Protect me, Master Builder! I've just heard hostile screams and a horrendous, unnatural wheeze. It's pitch dark outside. No, it isn't. No torches, no electric lights. I should visit the police station as soon as possible. Wait, the key to what, though? The guard lost the key to something? A storeroom. You mean the wine storeroom? I don't think I can get back in there, though. I tried clickety-clicking on the gatety-gate. Nothing happened, so this house is irrelevant. Unfortunate. Okay, but this must be the door I just came in, so... But this is just... This door's just gonna take me back out. His house key, but I don't need that. Do I? No. I don't even know why I'm doing this. It's just gonna run me right into the face of some guard who's gonna go... And so forth. So, yeah. I don't know. I really just don't know. Storeroom. Okay, you, I mean, I presume you're supposed to be here, right? Because what's that woman even doing? It's nonsense. What light is casting here? Okay, so if I jump up here, and then I jump up here. Oh, shit. And then I jump up there, I might be able to go in one of these windows, maybe? I don't know. That window's obviously, I can tell it's an object because of the edges and also you can see in, but I can't figure a way to actually... Maybe I gotta jump on those shutters. Oh my god, I can't even jump. Stupid bloody... Okay, I guess I can't go up there. Yeah, maybe if I just mantle up here, I might be able to jump right in. It's gonna be weird though. Yes. Well, this isn't the pub either, though, so I can't put them out. So, I would hope this isn't irrelevant. Oh boy. Well, Getting stuck is just a common occurrence in this mission. It's how you do it. That's how I do it, anyway. I am stuck there. Why did I unlock that? There's nothing in here. Oh, there is. Okay, fine. Oh, I see. That is the relevant window. Good. I am now calmed and have faith in my belief. Whoa. That's nonsense. Spooky, though. That almost looks glitchy, but no glitches behave like that. It's got, like, an animation for itself. If I wasn't familiar with the engine, I might call that a glitch, but it isn't. Because that just doesn't make any sense. Also, yeah, okay, so... This, oh yeah, this is this place where I lamented the death of Dio and all sorts of stuff. Whoa. Dang it. Didn't mean to do that. Probably can't get back up there, can I? Probably not. Alright, though. Alright. No messing around down there. Let's just gad about straight into the penny pub. Okay. So now I'm here. And... are these windows real actual windows?
Oh, Jesus!
Whoa! God. Well, that alerted everybody. All these scripted events alert people. Wow, that's... Wow. And I didn't even need to come down here? What am I looking for, anyways? A valuable dagger. Okay. Well, is it down here? Because why else would there be a scare? Perhaps it's like, this is the wrong place for you, dagger boy. The dagger will fall on your face. These doors aren't real. Weird. I guess it's just there to scare you. Make you think you gotta go there, but you don't. Now that I've alerted the whole town, which is gonna happen anyway, apparently, let's find that dagger! And end it off there. Okay? Okay. Yes, please stop barfing in the street. Nobody's impressed by that. No woman will come here for sure. No. Yeah. Well, leave the mad to their squirmings, that's what I say. Leave the mad to their squirmings. That's what I say. Huh. Interesting. But no dice, nor dagger, nor mad people. Okay. This is Penny's pub. Who knows if Penny's even here? She probably isn't, you know? This whole mission is about wild goose chases and mad runs. So who knows what's gonna be in this door? Some other jump scare? Almost certainly yes! Psyched up. Oh. Oh no! It's a god-awful bug. Ah, and there's a loop down here, so... That's why. Okay. Yeah, I don't know why I feel weird about the referencing other stuff. I guess it's cool. It's just weird to see... different sort of fan things happen in one. I don't know why I think it's kind of weird and stuff. I should be like, hey, that's cool, because in the dark mode I was like, hey, cool, other people are referencing Mandrasola and stuff. I don't know. Just take me by surprise or something. Alright, ready for the shock scare? It's not happening. The bed's empty. Not suspicious. Yet another lockpick, because why not just stand here and pick a lock whilst you're in no danger whatsoever? Of course. Still no thing. MacGuffin. Yeah, that's probably another cash thing, so. Alright. A lot of gawkers started to visit our district after the House of Science's windows began to emit blue fog. Alas, almost all of them usually reside in the Stumbled Wanderer, confound it. The only people who know about my pub are just local residents, whereas newcomers don't have a clue about it because of its unfortunate location. There was a time when I hired boys to drum up new customers, but this doesn't work now. A week ago, I eventually decided to order a signboard with an arrow. Truth be told, the sign, along with its placing, cost me a pretty penny.
Also, the carts with the ale that I half prepaid have disappeared into thin air. I desperately need more customers. Praise the builder. An earthquake happened today. From now on, all newcomers can only get into the city via our district. By the way, one of my lodgers disappeared. Seems he was just waiting for this moment to leave without paying me for his room. I've notified the police about him, but I believe that the knave has already left the city. To the trickster with him! He! Several gawkers that visited my pub today have brought me a 3-day profit. Good news! The city gawkers continue to arrive to watch the abyss and then visit my pub in order to have a drink. Some drunkard hired one of my rooms. He paid in advance for it and, once he crossed the threshold, plunked himself down on the bed.
Which is a totally normal behavior. Why would you write about it?
Wonderful! Another gap has appeared nearby, but the house of that Kennelly guy was saved by a miracle. Also, the mage inspectors have just arrived to investigate the recent events. One of them asked me about the room in my inn and promised a lot of cash. No problem, I said, and banished the drunkard. When I entered his room, he was snoring so hard that I had to throw cold water on him. I gave him back a part of his room charge and told him that I couldn't risk his life when everything is falling apart around us. Truth be told, I feel uneasy myself because of all these earthquakes, but money brings some relief. Wow! Today there were even more visitors in my pub. The catastrophe has lined my purse. What if I give my pub a new name? Say, the Fracture Side Pub. I think people do like the unusual. One of my customers once told me that he traveled 20 miles just to visit Martha's Tits Inn. Uh-huh. But all this is only good as long as my pub doesn't disappear tomorrow. What? I'm scared, yes, but nevertheless, my thirst for money is stronger than my fear. It's good that, at least you're self-aware, it's good that the mage is here. These mages are sinister guys. But I think everything is under their control, which means that I'm secure for a while. I'll put the last 3 days' receipts into my bank. No mention of a dagger? What? Penny. What? No mention? I see. It's not there even. You'd think it would be, but no. That's some great telling you where to go ever. Christ on a goddamn stick, man. What? The only place for me left to go is down here. Which, I mean, must be some reason to go here. Oh, there's some old guy thrashing about in the garbage. Better use a time ring. Fuck yourself, don't vomit on me. What? Why? Why is it even possible for me to go down here? Am I supposed to jump over the fence then? Nope. So, is this just to get me back up? You can't even. What? What? You're screwed if you go down here, is that what you're telling? Or is there rope? Do these things... You can't rope moving objects, can you? No, what about this? No, what about this? Okay. Still think you'd be hard-pressed. Anyway, that's it for today. See you guys next time, and bye for now.